Alright, I'm Paul Trash and I am Phil Rummage and we are Paul Trash and the Craft Map. Yeah.
Man, do I remember Pool Crash and the Trash Mats? They were just so good. They just used to go off. Their music was so innovative. They just were so fantastic. It was just the most amazing thing I'd ever seen. And oh, like they go boom, boom, and it was just everybody was up there on the dance floor and we were all just shaking our heads and it was just, oh, it was the wildest scene. It was just so good and so original. Oh, man.
And then all the time I used to go to concerts, they're just inspirational, they're ecstatic.
There was not an ounce of talent throughout the whole band.
There was a band round there right now, there'd be a line of people just waiting at the door, just dying to come in.
Like, every time I go into a crowd, it's always been the best crowd there is.
Trash, yeah, they got it right when you said Trash. And to be perfectly honest, I wouldn't have had anything to do with them except I was at work and I needed a job.
If only they had music like that now. Bang bang, Crash Mats.
Tops and all. Yeah. Hard to explain if you want.
We want to change our sound, you know. We don't want to just be, oh, you know, Pool Trash, Crash Mats, sounding the same forever.
Yeah. It's not punk just going out and buying an instrument. It's just, what do you even, like, you may as well just be living at home with your grandma. What's the point?
Even, you know, everyone's dad can play the guitar. Whose dad can make an instrument out of something around the house, you know?
Something that's not an instrument. We've been experimenting with so much stuff.
Sound number one, rubber chicken. Alright, sound number two. Scissors and paper.
Sound number three, zipper on my suitcase.
It's coffee pot and donga. It's kazoo, what I found. Sound number seven, boot hands.
Mission as Pool Trash and Crash Mats is to reinvent that punk sound and bring it back to the people in good honest ways. You know, we're tired of this just, you know, commercial instruments. Commercial.
Yeah, it's so unoriginal, like, oh look, I've got a guitar. Oh, mate. So what? You've got a musical instrument.
We lost
that's
our drummer
punk
and our keyboard player this year.
Yeah, but that's good because
We just got rid of them because we couldn't have that.
Crash and the Crash Mats really were pioneers of punk. Even without their drummer or their flute player, their live performances were unlike any other. However, when they started their more experimental music, bringing the chicken out on stage, audiences lost interest.
Boo!
What? Don't like the chicken?
This took a toll on the band, and things went south pretty quick.
People like even new stuff, but we just gotta keep doing it, man. And then eventually they'll warm up to it. You know, they're not used to it yet. We just gotta keep working on it, mate.
Can't see a way out of it. I'm not having a good time anymore.
It was at this point that Paul started going off the rails and getting far too trashed.
Would you say that Paul has lost control of his life?
I would definitely say that Paul Trash has lost control of his life. It's getting too much for everyone around him.
Remember about Paul Trash and the Crash Mats?
They turned to other bands such as Smelly Simon and the Silly Sods.
The Paul Trash and the Crash Mats?
I'm more of a Smelly Simon fan, to be honest.
We've had nothing to do with Smelly Simon and the Silly Sods, and I've had it up to here for those rumours.
I have not actually talked about this to Paul yet, but at this point in time, I will not be joining Paul Trash and the Crash Mats again. Smelly Simon has made me an incredible offer that I can't turn down. Sometimes you've just got to know when to leave the sinking ship. I don't even know if he's gonna pick up. I think it's time.
Sorry.
Hi, Paul. It's Phil. It's Phil Rummage.
Sometimes, you know, it just takes a big rubber chicken to come and hit you in the face and knock you down just so you can get back up. Keep making music.
Paul Trash and his best friend Phil Rummage went on to create the best punk album of all time and are still some of the most influential?
Did you say influential?
Punk musicians today.
Influential is not a word I would associate with our band.
Leave the rubbish on the floor, it's not punk at all. Come on.
I think the floor's on fire.